Sorry, Mom. Yeah, Mum, are you sure?
I know, Jack, but that's not the point. We just want to come to you and take it ourselves. And we'll never mind when it comes. I need you to go for a lot of more around here.
But...
No, but I have very concerned.
Why did you say that? Why did you get away from how concerned Mum is?
Oh, leave me alone, Jack. The house?
Yes, the house. And the father and the
father. Oh, I didn't think about that. How can we help?
We need something over the hour of
this. Ew, no way.
Jane, what did I just say?
Oh, right. What?
This man offered me some magic beans for Daisy. Yeah, you can't see it.
We needed the money from Daisy to keep the farm and the house.
But he said it was magic beans.
from Daisy to keep the farm and the house.
But he said...
He said that it would not have been him. Well, I think he was saying that our own.
Then what was your promise?
That's all now!
That night, Jack went to bed without any sleep. His mother was nervous that he would be able to send him home. And Jack was so upset that he said that he would not have sent him home.
Jack found a kitchen with huge bowls and chairs the height of buildings. Yeah, go from there.
Jack found some chairs, some huge chairs and huge bowls.
Give me a second. Okay. Can we go across?
Yeah.
Okay. So he found cutlery, a knife, fork, and spoon. Yeah? Okay, go from there. Fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll have his bones to grind my bread. Fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll have his bones to grind my bread.
So the giant sat getting his breakfast while Jack hid in the corner of the room. He was shaking like a leaf. He'd read about Jack's in his storybooks and he knew not to get out of that.
Jack's wife had finished her breakfast, the dad began to get comfy and ready for his mid-morning nap. From the corner of the room, Jack spotted a basket full of golden eggs and a sickly looking white hen. The giant poked the hen and growled and bled, and the hen laid an egg and made a bowl which the giant added to the basket. From the closest, the giant pulled out a heart with the face to the side of the milk. The giant poked the heart and growled and bled, and the heart began to play gentle tune while the lovely face sang a lullaby. Soon the giant began to nod and snore until the whole house shook. Jack spotted an opportunity to leave, so he snuggled quietly and quickly as he could towards the door. But just as he was about to leave, he heard the sound of the heart going boom. Jack bit his lip, sighed, and returned to the kitchen. Jack grabbed the sickly hen and the singing heart and began to tiptoe back out. But this time the hen gave a cackle, which woke Jack from his nap.
Wife, wife, what have you done with my white hen and my golden heart?
Jack ran as fast as he could, and the giant, realizing he had been tricked, came rushing after him. Away from the castle, down the broad, winding road. The giant was only 20 yards away when he looked down and saw Jack disappear. Confused, he peered through the clouds and saw Jack climbing down for dear life.
Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll have his bones to grind my bread.
Mum, Jane,
what on earth? Jack, we could sell the golden eggs for money.
The singing heart found Jack Christ from her from the giant. She'd hated being locked up in the closet all day now, and wanted nothing more than to sit in the farmhouse window and sing to the birds and butterflies in the sunshine. With a bit of patience and his mother's help, it didn't take long for Jack to get the sickly hen back in good health, and the grateful hen continued to lay fresh golden eggs every day.
Now it's time enough for both of us. from the sun. We can be who.